For the last few weeks, I've been playing around with this 30-watt desktop CO2 laser, and in this video, I'm going to share what I learned, an overview of what it can do, and answer the question on every 3D printing maker's mind. Should you get one too? Let's dive in. Ever since this channel started getting traction, and thanks, as always, to all of you for that, my inbox has been absolutely flooded with offers of every kind of laser, from big enclosed frickin' laser beams to add-on diodes for my 3D printers to massive open-air suckers with work areas about as big as I am. Which, I guess, isn't saying all that much because I'm pretty short. Fortunately, I discovered a video from Angus over at Maker's Muse pretty early on, which informed me that open lasers were more dangerous than
sharks with frickin' laser beams attached to their heads.
And so, with two young kids at home and a tiny office space with really poor ventilation, I've been passing up on all of these review units. What can I say? Call me sentimental, but I really like that my kids can see. So imagine my schoolboy-esque excitement when I stumbled upon the Taiwanese company FLUX at Formnext 2022. For those of you who don't know, FLUX makes high-end, fully enclosed CO2 lasers and laser accessories that look more like polished appliances than dangerous children's toys. Looking at their insane booth at Formnext, I got really excited about everything that I could possibly make with a laser. So, we got to schmoozing, and one thing led to another, and FLUX was generous enough to offer me their massive 60-watt industrial-level Hexa unit to try out. But before you hobbyists click away and you pros get all excited, there's good news and there's bad news. The bad news is, as I never tire of reminding you all, I have no room left in this office, and I haven't found a space I can rent out just yet. At it just over a meter in length, not to mention a $7,000 price tag, I honestly felt like the Hexa unit was not as good of a fit for me or for any of you in the audience. So while I felt like my fingers were betraying me, I wrote to FLUX and politely declined their very generous offer. Don't say I don't love you guys. The good news though is that FLUX also makes a super compact, fully enclosed 30-watt CO2 laser called the beamo. Now what's cool about the beamo is that it is exactly as big as the laser tube needs to be for cooling and so on, and no bigger. And while I still dream of cutting my own custom panels for a boron build, or designing my very own Repbox-inspired filament enclosure along the entirety of my wall using a giant laser, saner heads prevailed, and I asked FLUX to instead send me the smaller and more affordable beamo unit alongside their integrated FLUX beam air filtration and exhaust system, which helps ensure that I don't poison myself and my offspring with styrene fumes when I try all different kinds of materials. Because the beamo boasts the ability to cut and engrave all manner of thin materials, and many of them can emit toxic fumes while you do it. Though I definitely still smell a lot of what I'm cutting, and this thing is incredibly loud while it's working, so I probably won't be using this thing in such a small space anyways, once I can find a place to rent. Now, I do want to stop at this point and clarify that this is not a review. FLUX did provide me with this unit free of charge in exchange for me doing a video about it, and while no money changed hands, I definitely don't feel like I have enough experience with laser cutters, given that this is my first one ever, to actually give a review and compare it. So for the rest of this video, I'm just going to be sharing my experience as a seasoned maker but laser newbie, the surprising things that I learned, and also my thoughts and feelings as to whether this is a good addition to your maker repertoire. Now, if you want to see a full review, Stefan from CNC Kitchen did one on this exact machine, and I highly recommend you check it out. Oh, and by the way, speaking of adding capabilities to your maker repertoire, I do need to take a quick moment to thank this video's sponsor, because as I mentioned, I did not accept any payment from FLUX for this video, but somebody has to pay for all the materials I destroyed while testing this thing out. That somebody is PCBWay, and they're a great fit for this video and this channel because whatever it is that you're building, PCBWay can help make it better. From the name, I'm sure that you understand that they make custom PCBs for insanely affordable prices, but they also do industrial 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, metal 3D printing, CNC machining, injection molding, and a whole lot more. So the next time that you reach the limits of what you can do with your own 3D printer or laser cutter, make sure to visit the link in the description below to check out PCBWay. Thanks to PCBWay for supporting this channel, and thanks to all of you for supporting the people who support me. Okay, let's get this thing set up. FLUX was kind enough to provide me with the autofocus add-on, and while that is much appreciated, I was unlucky and got one that had some kind of issues with the boards, and I still don't really get along with the autofocus module, to be honest. Fortunately, though, this gave me a chance to test out their customer service, and they were kind enough to connect me to Yehuda at 3DBot X, which is their local reseller, who literally picked it up from 2 hours away, fixed it, and then dropped it off, which is a massive credit to both companies. And having gotten to know Yehuda since then, I'm pretty sure that I would have gotten similar service, though probably not with door-to-door service and pickup, even if I weren't a content creator. In any case, I will admit that it took me some time to really get set up with the BeamO and the software, including aligning the laser after its trip up north, figuring out how to use the software, and so on. But as you all know by now, I really don't have anyone to blame for that because I have a nasty habit of storing the instructional manuals safely away in the closet, unread. Fortunately, after going through a bunch of FLUX's very helpful YouTube videos and clips, I was able to get the laser fired up, no pun intended, and ready to do my first project. So, now what? And here we run into the first major issue that I had and the reason that I've actually been putting off this video for months. What the heck do I make with this thing? You see, when I first sought out FLUX and got excited about getting a laser cutter, I had big visions of all the things that I'd build. Filament dry boxes, custom enclosures, heck, maybe I'll even cut massive wooden boards with it. Anyone want to use jigsaw? I ordered a bunch of plexiglass and balsa wood and eagerly planned how I would level up my entire maker status to multi-production method. But very quickly, I realized that the BeamO's relatively small work area, about the size of an A4 piece of paper, meant that I wasn't really going to be making a whole lot of anything. I cut a small piece of plexiglass for a window in a dry box and designed a lovely custom reflection surface for my 3D printed teleprompter, but then I drew a blank. Sure, I could cut all kinds of craft papers, fabrics, and things like that, but I already have a Cricut maker that I don't use for that. I posted on the channel's community tab, I opened up a channel on Discord asking for inspirations, but nothing came. So I reached out to other content creators, I scoured through YouTube, all in search of the answer to what exactly I could actually make with this machine. Then, a breakthrough. I discovered boxes.py, a library of customizable boxes and other accessories that you can turn into laser cutting files. And I even made a wooden two-piece 3D printing spool and a wooden tissue box. But coming from the world of 3D printing with its limitless possibilities, I immediately decided that these boxes were honestly uglier, less customizable, and a lot more manual work than just designing and 3D printing something from scratch. Yeah, I made the filament spool and I made the box for the tissues, but my heart just wasn't in it. Working with wood, at least wood of this thickness, felt so limiting. To be honest with you guys, it's at this point that I almost gave up. I asked myself, are desktop laser cutters just a gimmick? A novelty tool which has very little real practical application? Have I just become so spoiled by the possibilities of a 3D printer that working with thin, two-dimensional materials has nothing to offer me? And that's when it hit me, a real breakthrough. This isn't just a laser cutter, it's also a laser engraver. And as I dug into some of the content from content creators in the laser making space, I realized something massive. They aren't really making anything. They are customizing, personalizing, and decorating existing things. And it was then that I realized that I was looking at this machine all wrong. I was applying an additive manufacturing lens to it and trying to make something out of nothing instead of understanding the true strengths of this machine. The ability to recklessly abuse and destroy existing materials and products. From that moment on, everything changed. No more was I trying to find ways to use this laser cutter to make something just for the sake of making it. No more did I have a tool looking for a purpose. Suddenly, I changed my mindset, and instead, I started looking for ready-made materials and products that I could tweak, customize, and personalize. And personalize, I did. Whereas in the past, I'd put custom cut stickers on things with my Cricut machine, now I could toss anything, so long as it was 45 millimeters or less in height, under the laser and personalize it to my heart's content. iPad cases? Check. Wooden trivets? Check. Leather wallet? Check. Hairbrushes? Double check. Decorative cheese platters for gifts? Check. In fact, the only things I wasn't able to customize or personalize were metal or aluminum, which I would need a more powerful unit or a diode laser attachment to successfully destroy. Now we're having fun. You might say to yourself, Jonathan, this is ridiculous. You're using a $2,200 machine to do a task that you could do with a $2 magic marker. And you're making stuff that you could probably buy at a dollar store, albeit not fully personalized. And to that, I reply, so? And also, I'll remind you that many of you, or us, are 3D printing storage bins that we could buy at Walmart for less. What I mean to say is this. Being a maker isn't about finding the cheapest or even the most practical way to accomplish a task. It's about being able to express yourself in whatever medium you want to bring your own vision to life. And if your vision involves toasting your face onto the last piece of bread so no one else in your family eats it, then the FLUX beamo is the machine for you, baby. Just don't try to use right-to-left text like Hebrew or Arabic, because while it shows up perfectly in the software, your wife will probably be a whole lot less amused when you engrave an anagram of her name onto her wallet. But is it worth it? In all seriousness, I think we now have to ask the question, who should actually get a laser cutter? Is it worth the amount of money that you're going to spend on it, not to mention the space it's going to take up in your shop or basement? Naturally, all that really depends on who you are and what you want to make. If, for example, you really want to be able to work with wood in a precise way, cut acrylic, fabric, and leather, and add that to your 3D prints, well, then a laser cutter is a no-brainer. If you really love the idea of customizing things ranging from ceramics to different types of woods, then it makes a ton of sense. And even if you want to add glass to your projects, it might make sense as well, because a CO2 laser can indeed engrave glass for you. I think it's definitely worth asking yourself, at least if you, like me, have a lot of 3D printers, is another 3D printer really going to level up your ability and repertoire and range of things that you can make as a maker? Is another faster 3D printer going to challenge you to learn new skills and keep you engaged as much as learning a whole new medium or process like this will? And yet, at the same time, you are still very much limited with what you can actually do using a laser cutter, or at least a safe laser cutter that is fully enclosed. First, there's the work area size, and of course, the depth of materials that you can cut. Then, there's the fact that there are far fewer designs available out there, and much less of an open source culture where everyone shares their designs. While I really expected to find a website similar to Printables or Things, I was honestly disappointed to find only a few low-quality sites with a handful of design files, many of them requiring payment. Yes, you can just import any image and work with that, but if you want to do something intricate and sophisticated that really takes advantage of the laser, it is better to have proper design files for a laser cutter. And as I said before, coming from the nearly endless possibilities of 3D printing, it definitely takes some time to get used to this new tool and its limitations. I guess, all in all, this whole experience really did just make me appreciate how versatile and powerful 3D printing is as a maker technology. For me, personally, I'm really happy to have this laser around for when I do want to precisely cut something or make a thoughtful and personalized gift for friends and family. And I actually used this to make some very precise cuts for an upcoming project video, so stay tuned for that. And I will admit that I've been eyeing the rotary add-on for this machine because I'm getting really tired of my son, and let's face it, my wife, losing all their water bottles and needing to replace them all the time. And I definitely think that if I were more serious about running my Etsy shop, I could do so much more and create so many more incredible products with this laser cutter. But I do have to admit that for my own personal hobbyist uses around the house, I don't think I could justify spending more than like $500 on a laser cutter. And that, unfortunately, would restrict me to a much lower quality and flat-out unsafe open design with no air filtration. Now, maybe that would make sense if I were in a big open garage or workshop which already had a fume vent, but for personal, at-home use and with my kids running around all the time and doing projects with me, it's just not something that I'm willing to risk. Hey, editing Jonathan here. So my whole family and I got COVID and our entire country almost slipped into a dictatorship. So I haven't had a chance to re-record some parts of the video, but after I sent a draft to the folks at FLUX Europe, they shared with me a few points in response to some of the things that I had to say, and they asked me to include them in this video. First and foremost, in response to the fact that laser cutters are much more limiting, they let me know that it's still really early days and the ecosystem for laser cutters isn't nearly as developed yet as it is for 3D printers. Now they are working on changing that by creating things like TinkerShare, which is the exact thing I was looking for when I looked for a Thingiverse alternative. And indeed, while there aren't millions of models out there yet like there are for 3D printers, I did discover some really, really cool ones. They also agreed with me that laser cutters aren't intended to replace a 3D printer, but are instead a great complement to it, adding new capabilities like wood, acrylic, and etching to your workflow, and that it's better to think about them as complementary tools, not so much competitive ones. Especially because with a laser cutter, it's just going to be much, much faster to make certain things than even with the fastest of 3D printers. And that's especially true because even with the fastest 3D printer, some things are just going to be faster to cut on a laser cutter out of something like acrylic. One other thing that they let me know was that because of the relative simplicity of just X and Y, laser cutters are a more approachable on-ramp into the maker scene, and this combined with the safety features of a fully enclosed laser like the FLUX beamo makes it actually a really popular product with schools and makerspaces. Though this video might have come off a bit harsh on laser cutters overall, I do agree with all of these points, and like I said, a laser cutter could be a great addition to your maker repertoire if you have the budget. But hey, let me know in the comments below what you think. Do you want a laser cutter? And if so, I would love suggestions of what you would make with it. I'm sure I missed some opportunities to really take advantage of this machine. A huge thanks again to the folks at FLUX for sending me this unit to play with, another thanks to PCBWay for sponsoring this channel, and a big thanks to my Patreon supporters, as always, for supporting my goal of doing this full time. Oh, and thanks to all of you for watching and liking and subscribing, because that really does make a difference. That's all for now, but I'll see all of you on the next layer.